Hello friends, I am Maunika. Hope you all are good and safe. Welcome back to Learn HTML. Happy to see you all again in this HTML course. A warm welcome to you all. In today's video, we are going to continue the concept of forms. In previous video also, we discussed the concept of forms, right? In previous video, we discussed what is form, what is mean by form filling, and we discussed how to code simple login form in our HTML web page. For that purpose, we learned three types of inputs: text inputs, password inputs, and submit inputs, right? And we coded our first simple login form in our HTML web page. These steps we discussed in previous video. So if you don't know those steps, or if you didn't watch my previous videos, I will provide link of my entire playlist detailed HTML course in my description box. Kindly check over there. I request you to watch my previous videos, because if you watch my previous videos, you can get a better continuity over here. Okay. Now let's enter into today's content. Before entering into today's content, if you didn't subscribe my channel, kindly subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you will receive all notifications of my videos then and there. Okay. Now, without further delay, let's enter into today's content. So this is what the agenda for today. In today's video, we are going to discuss how to code radio button, checkbox, and drop down menu in HTML web page. Okay, for that purpose, we are going to learn three more types of inputs: number inputs, radio inputs, and checkbox inputs. And we are going to learn two more tags: select tag and option tag. Okay, so this is what the agenda for today. So today we'll be coding radio button, checkbox, and drop down menu in our HTML web page. Means we will be coding on form which includes radio button, checkbox, and drop down menu, right? So this is what the agenda for today. Okay, so instead of explaining here, let me explain practically with the help of text editor and web browser so we can understand better. Okay, so first, let me open my text editor and web browser. As you all know, I'm using Sublime text editor, right? So let me open my text editor. So this is what my text editor. Okay, so this is what our file, right? index.html. This is what our file, right? So let me open my browser also. So this is what our file, index.html, my first HTML web page, right? So this web page we have created in last few videos. We can continue here. In last video, we created the sample login form, right? Username, password, and login. For that, we learned three types of inputs: text input, password input, and submit input. For username, we are using text input. For password, to mask the characters, we are using password input. And to code this login button, we are using submit input, right? So now we are going to code this form. Okay, this form includes radio button, checkbox, and drop down menu, right? So this is what radio button, we can select anything, okay? But we can select only one. We can select either male, or we can select female, or we can select others. We cannot select both male and female. Similarly, we cannot select both female and others. We cannot select both male and others. We can select either one. Okay, so if you want your user to select predefined choices, you can use a radio button. Okay, for example, if you want your user to select gender, you may use this type of radio button also. Or if you want your user to select marital status, you may use this radio button, like single, married, or divorce, something. Okay, similarly, checkbox. Okay, if you want your user to choose multiple choices, like user can have many skills, right? Here, user can have artificial intelligence, web development, graph theory, and so on. User can have many skills. It is not like that one user should have only one skill. No, right? So user can have many skills, right? But here, user can have only one gender, right? Here, user can have many skills, right? So if you want to code this type of checkboxes, we'll be discussing how to code this type of checkboxes. We'll be discussing this in today's video. Similarly, drop down menu. So if you want your user to choose birth month, you can code like this drop down menu. Okay, if you want your chooser to choose like this, you can code like this. Okay, we'll be discussing how to code this drop down menu in today's video. So this is what radio button, checkbox, and drop down menu. So in previous video we discussed how to code this text box and this password input. For coding phone number, we'll be using number input. Why? Because for coding phone number, we cannot use characters, right? So user should give number alone. Okay, user should not type characters, right? User should not type any characters. Okay, you want your user to type number alone here. Okay, in this field, you want your user to type numbers, right? So in the field which is dedicated to phone number, user cannot type any text, right? That is invalid, right? So better you can code this with the help of number input. Okay, so don't worry, in today's video we are going to code this form. Okay, so we'll be discussing each and everything in detail, so don't worry. So this is what we are going to code today. Okay, so for that, let me open my text editor. We can code here. Okay, we can code here. Okay, now first there is heading, right? Register form. Let me code it. Okay, so you can use any heading tag according to size. So I'm going to use H3 heading tag. Okay, if you want more bigger, you can use either H1 or H2. If you want smaller, you can use H4, H5, H6. No problem. You can use any heading tag according to size. So what is the heading here? A register form, right? So let me type it over here. Okay, so let me close it here. Okay, if a particular tag is open, the particular tag should get closed, right? So Control S. Let me show you in my browser. Now here you can see heading is appeared, right? Now so far we coded this heading alone. Okay, now we are going to code this form, right? Now we are going to code this form. So what does mean by form? If you want to get some input from your user, or if we can say if you want to get some input from someone, we will be using form. Okay, through forms we can get input from someone. Okay, by filling form we are giving our own data to someone. Okay, so if you want to get some data from someone, if you want to get someone's data, you can get it by using forms. Okay, so to code form, we need to open and close form tab, right? So between opening and closing tab, we can code that content. These steps we discussed in previous video also. So now we are going to code form. So let me open form tab and let me close it over here. Okay, so between opening tag and closing tag, I'm going to code the content, right? Between opening tag and closing tag, I'm going to code the content. Okay, so now here you can see first name, last name, password and phone number. These four things are paragraph? No, right? As I said in previous video, these things are not paragraph. Okay, first name, last name, password and phone number. These things are not paragraph. Then what is this? What are these? See, first name. So for first name is a label to this particular field. Similarly, last name is label to this particular field. Similarly, password is a label to this particular field. Similarly, phone number is a label to this particular phone number field, right? So if you use paragraph tag, physical appearance may be same. Okay, but label is the appropriate tag to code this. Okay, if you use paragraph tag, physical appearance may be same, but meaning is incorrect. Logic is incorrect. So if you want to code this first name, last name, password and phone number, the appropriate tag is label tag. Why? Because these things are labeled to the respective fields, right? So first name is labeled to this field, last name is labeled to this field, password is a label to this particular password field. Similarly, phone number is a label to this particular phone number field, right? So appropriate tag to code this is label tag, right? So let me open a label tag here. Okay, let me open label tag here. Let me close it over here. Okay, now here I'm going to use first name, because first name is of type label, right? So let me code it. Similarly, let me do it for last name also. Let me open label tag and let me close it over here. Now here I'm going to code the content. What is the content? Last name is the content. Okay, so this particular statement instructs our computer, this content last name is of label type. Okay, it's of label type. If you use paragraph tag, physical appearance may be same, but that particular statement will instruct our computer this content is of paragraph type. This is not paragraph type, right? So label tag is appropriate tag. Okay, so by seeing this statement, okay, by seeing this statement, our system can understand this last name is of type label. Last name is label to some particular field. Okay, so similarly, let me code it for password and phone number also. Label, let me close it over here. Okay, here let me type password. So password is the label, right? Between an opening tag and closing tag, we need to code the content, right? Okay, let me do the same for phone number also. Let me close it over here. Okay, let me type the content as phone number. Now let me save it, Control S, and let me show in my browser what you can see. The labels, right? You can see this labels, first name, last name, password and phone number. You can see this labels, right? So we code it by using appropriate tag, label tag. Okay, now what we are going to do is that we are going to code this text box. Okay, we are going to code this field. Okay, we are going to code this field, or we can say for first name it is text box, right? We are going to code this text box now. Okay, so to code text box, what we need to do, we need to open input tag, right? With these steps we discussed in previous video to code this particular type of form. I'm explaining this once again. Okay, so I'm going to use input tag here. Okay, if you want to get some input from the user, you need to use the input tag. Okay, so in the type attribute you need to specify the type. Okay, here I'm going to use text type. Okay, text type. Okay, now name attribute. So what is the main purpose of name attribute? These things I explained in previous video also. See, the main purpose of name attribute is there to make our web server to understand, okay, to make our web server to understand the value of the particular field. So this is what the main purpose of name attribute. So let me specify some name here. Let me specify first name. Okay, so here as you can see, there is some text inside the field, right? So how to achieve this? We can achieve this by using placeholder attribute, right? So I'm going to use placeholder attribute here. Okay, I'm going to use placeholder attribute here. What is inside this field? First name, right? So let me type first name here. Okay, so let me close it. Now Control S. First text box is appeared, right? So we coded these things. Okay, so far we coded this text box alone. Now similarly, we are going to code last name, password and phone number. We are going to code the text box, or you can say we are going to code the fields, the appropriate fields for last name, password and phone number, right? So now let me code the same for last name also. So if you want to get some input from user, we will be using input tag, right? So let me use input tag. So what is type of the input? So in type attribute, we need to give, or we need to specify the value as text, because last name is also text, right? First name is also text, last name is also text. So we'll be specifying value as text. Okay, similarly name, you can specify any name. Okay, see, here you can see some text is there inside this particular field. So to achieve this, we will be using placeholder attribute. Okay, we'll be using placeholder attribute. Okay, here you can see what text is there, last name, right? So so that particular text we need to give as a value to this particular attribute, last name. So let me close the tag. Now let me save and show you. Now you can see text box for last name is also available, right? Now let me code password and phone number. Password also we discussed in previous video. I want to get some input from the user. So let me open input tag. Okay. So type, what is the type? Password type, right? So if you specify extra type, your password will be visible to others also. Okay. So if you want to mask the characters of the password, or we can say if you want to mask the letters of the password, the letters of the password should get masked. For that purpose, we will be using input type as password, right? So name attribute. Okay, we can specify any name. Let me specify password. Okay, so inside that you can see the text as password, right? So let me use placeholder attribute. Okay, so let me specify password. Okay, let me close it over here. Control S. Now let me show in my browser. Here you can see password field also available, right? Now phone number is pending, right? Now I want to get some input from the user, right? So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to open input tag. So input is one of the self-closing tag, right? So these tags I explained in previous video. Input tag is one of the self-closing tag, okay? Because there is no content, the tags without any content, we'll be calling it a self-closing tag. Okay, input is one of the self-closing tags. Okay, so here, what is the type? See, if you specify text type, user may enter some letters in the phone number, in the field of phone number, right? So if you specify password type, the letters will be masked. So to code the phone number, the appropriate input type is number. Okay, so this particular input type will allow the end user, or we can say will allow our website visitors, okay, will allow our website visitors to enter numbers alone in this particular field. Okay, if you press some character, it won't, there will be no reaction. Okay, there will be no action. Okay, so this particular input type will allow our user, or we can say this particular input type will restrict our user to type characters other than numbers. Okay, this particular input type will allow the user to type numbers alone. Okay, this particular input type will allow our user to type numbers alone. Other than numbers, you cannot specify any characters or any symbols there. Okay, so this is what this particular input type. Similarly, let me give some name. Okay, if you specify name attribute, then only that particular data or that particular stuff, okay, will be sent to server. Okay, otherwise server doesn't know which is username, which is password, which is last name, which is first name, which is phone number. Server cannot identify. As an end user, we can identify this by seeing this first name, last name, password, phone number. By seeing this label, end user can identify. To make our web server to identify the specific fields like first name, last name, password and phone number, we'll be using name attribute. Okay, so name attribute, let me specify some name here. Let me specify phone number. Okay, so inside it I have some default text, right? So not default, some text is inside there, right? So let me code it by using phone number, by using placeholder, sorry, placeholder attribute. Okay, let me code it for phone number by using placeholder attribute. Okay, so in placeholder attribute, let me specify the value as phone number. Let me close it over here. Control S. Let me show in my browser. Okay, here let me use line break tags also, then you can understand. It be a break rule tag. Okay, similarly let me use for other fields also. So let me copy this and let me paste it over here. Now save it and let me show you now. Now you can see, right? So first name, last name, password, phone number. So far we coded these steps alone. Okay. Now let me code this button, send button. Okay. After that, let me explain these three things. Okay. So first, let us code this send button. Okay. So for that, I'm going to get input from user. Okay. What input means user should click. Okay. After filling first name, last name, password, phone number, and remaining steps, user should click that send button. Okay. Then only that steps will send to web server, right? That steps will send to server. Okay. So let me open input tag. Okay. Input tag. Input is one of the self-closing tag. Let me specify type as submit. Okay. So let me specify some name over here. Okay. Submit button, or we can specify anything, no problem. Okay. Now let me save and show you. Control S. Now you can see submit button is there. Okay. So if you want the value in the submit button to be sent, so you can specify the value attribute, right? So value. Okay. Let me give send. Now you can see there, send, right? So far we coded this first name, last name, password, phone number, and this button. So we'll be discussing these steps. Don't worry. Okay. Now let me enter some first name here. Okay. Let me enter some last name. Okay. Let me enter some password over here. Here you can see we cannot enter anything other than numbers. Okay. If you press some letters, there won't be any action. Okay. For that purpose, we are using number type. Okay. If you want to mask the characters, you need to use password type. If you use text type like this, the characters in the password also will be visible to others. Okay. Similarly, if you want to get number alone, okay, if you want to get input in the phone number field, if you want to get input from the user, okay, user should enter number alone. So for that purpose, we'll be using number. Okay, number type. Okay, input type as number. So we can specify any number here, like some number. Okay, so here if you want to increase the number, you can increase. Okay, if you want to decrease the number, you can decrease. Okay, so this is what the number input type. Okay, by this arrow mark, you can increase the number. Similarly, by this arrow mark, you can decrease the number. Okay, so now let me send it. Let me click the send button. Now here you can see first name, last name, my password, and my phone number, and my submit button, right? These steps I discussed in previous video also. So actually what is happening, the name of the field and the value of the field appended in URL, right? So this is what our URL, right? Okay, so what name we gave there? So for this, I gave first name. Here I gave last name. Okay. Here I gave name as password. Here I gave name as phone number. Right. Here I gave name as sub-dut. Okay. So you can see these name here. First name, last name, password. Okay. Phone number, this name, and sub-dut. Okay, so similarly value, I gave first name as Maunika, right? I gave last name as put for year. I gave password as HTML. Okay, I gave phone number as these things 1234566. Okay, so in submit button, what is the value here? Send, right? This is what the value. So as you can see the value here. Okay, so what actually happening? The value of the field and the name of the field, the name of the field and value of the field, okay, converted into query strings. This is what query strings, right? name is equal to value. Okay, I discussed query strings in previous video. So the name of the field and the value of the field and the corresponding value of the field, what name you specified here, that name is equal to corresponding value, or we can say the value given by the user for that particular field, is converted into query string and appended in URL. So this is what actually happening, right? So these steps we learned. Okay, so this is what the main purpose of name attribute. Okay, if you want, see this username, let me zoom it. See this first name, last name, password, phone number, these are labels. By seeing these labels or by seeing the text inside this field, end user can understand I want to type first name here, or we can say this particular field is dedicated to first name, this particular field is dedicated to last name, this particular field is dedicated to password, like this end user can understand. But to make our web server to understand, we are using name attribute. Okay, web server don't know these details. Web server doesn't know these details, first name, last name, password, phone number. Web server doesn't know about these labels and doesn't know about the value of placeholder attribute, right? So web server only know the value of the name attribute and the value which is entered by the user. Okay, so these things will be converted into query strings and these things will appended in URL. So this is what actually happening. For that purpose, we need to specify name attribute for each and every field. For each and every field, name attribute should be unique, right? Okay, so we cannot specify same name here. Like if you specify first name, and here also if you specify first name, web server will keep two details for first name. Okay, first name equal to Monica, similarly first name equal to foot for year. Okay, so to avoid that confusion, name, the value of the name attribute should be unique for each and every fields, right? So this is what actually happening here. Okay, now we may proceed. So far we coded up to these four fields: first name, last name, password, phone number, and this send button, right? Now let me explain how to code this radio button. Okay, how to code this radio button. If you want to get input from your user, like gender, marital status, and for appointment order, like if you want to get some input for working days, like Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and so on, you can use this radio button. Here I'm using this for gender, right? So let me explain how to code this. Okay, for that let me open my text editor. Okay, first here gender is a label, right? So gender is not paragraph, gender is a label, right? So let me open label tag here and let me close it over here. Okay, here gender is a label, right? So gender. Now controllers, let me put some line breaks here. Okay, now let me show you. Now you can see gender is here. Okay, so send these things should get coded prior to this, right? So finally we need to code that submit button, right? So let me copy and paste it over here. Now let me show you. Here you can see. If you want, you can add line breaks also. Okay, so let me add line breaks over here. Now here you can see gender, the label is available, right? So far we coded this label alone. Now what we need to do, we need to code this radio button, right? How to code this? Here also I'm getting some input from user, right? So by using input tag, or we can say with the help of input tag, okay, with the help of input tag, I'm going to code this. Okay, so let me open input tag. Okay, let me specify input type as radio. Okay, if you want to code radio button, you need to specify input type as radio. Okay, input type as radio. Okay, So let me specify name for it, like some name like Dean. You can specify any name, okay? But your name should be understandable for you, okay? Okay, web server contains this value only. By seeing this value, you should understand, okay? GEN stands for gender. That means by seeing the value, see, web server contains name and value pair, right? By seeing that value, if value is male, means we need to understand it will contain gen equal to male. By seeing GEN, you need to understand because this name will be coded by you, right? As a designer, this name will be coded by you. You need to understand. Gender is male, like this. Okay, web server contains name value pair, the value of the name attribute and the value which was entered by user. Okay, so this particular thing should be understandable for you. Okay, so now let me close it. Okay, similarly, let me do it for three times because I have three things, right? Male, female, others, right? So let me copy it for two more times. Okay, now what I'm going to do is that I'm going to give a label here. Why? Because male is a label. Okay, female is a label. Others is a label. Okay, so let me give label here. It is not paragraph. So let me give label and let me close it over here. So male. Similarly, let me do it here also. Female. Similarly, here also. Others. Okay. Now, let me show you in my browser. See, you can see. Let me use line break here. Now, let me reload it. Now here you can see, right? You can select anything. Okay, you can select anything. Okay, user can select anything. If you want your user to select predefined choices, you can code this by using radio button. Okay, now see, let me select any value like female. Okay, let me send what actually there. See, you can see gender is on, right? Like that only you can see. Here you can see I didn't specify anything for first name, last name and password and that. Okay, so there is no value. Okay, similarly, I specified something for gender. I click female. But here you can see gender equal to on. That's it. Okay, that's why it's showing on. That means what? User specified something. But you don't know. Your web server will contain these things only. By seeing your URL, you cannot find out what actually the user has chosen. Okay, what actually the user has chosen. Okay, to find that thing, what you are going to do is that, what we are going to do is that, we'll be specifying value attribute. You need to specify some value over here, like male, female. Okay, similarly here, like others. Okay. Now let me save it. Control S. Let me show in my browser. See, now. Okay. Now let me click some gender. Let me click male. Send. See, now you can see gen equal to male, right? So for that purpose, we need to specify some value. Okay, we need to know which input is selected by our user, right? So for that purpose, you need to specify value here. Okay, if you specify value, that value will be visible in the URL. Okay, if you didn't specify any value, if user selects something, it will show simply on. You cannot find out which choice is selected by your user. Right, now let me select something like others. See, you can see now value is others, right? So by seeing this, you can understand, well, this chosen is this user is chosen this value like this. Okay, let me choose some other thing like female. Now you can see over here, right? So for that purpose we need to specify value. Okay, for that purpose you need to specify value. Okay, so far we coded this gender also. Okay, so by using radio input we can code like this. If you want your user to choose some predefined, if you want your user to choose some choices like this, gender or marital status or something, okay, or we can say if you want your user to choose predefined choices, okay, you can code like this. Okay, but with the help of radio button, okay, with the help of radio button you can achieve this. With the help of radio input you can code this. Okay, now so far we coded this gender also, still these two things remaining, right? So in our agenda we have seen how to code radio button. Now we are going to see how to code checkbox. In input we have seen number inputs and radio inputs. To code checkbox we will be using checkbox inputs. Okay, now after that we'll be seeing two tags, select tag and option tag. Okay, now let me explain this. See, why we are using radio button? If you want your user to choose some specific choices, you will be using this radio button, right? But see, skills, a particular user can have more than one skills, but here a particular user can have only one gender. Okay, a particular user can be male, maybe male or female or maybe others, right? But an user can have many skills. Okay, so we need to provide the facility to select more than one options. We can select more than one options. Okay, if user has more skills he can select more than one option. Okay, so this thing we'll be calling it as checkbox. Okay, multiple choices, this thing we'll be calling it as checkbox. Okay, checkbox. Now let me explain how to code this checkbox. Okay, how to code this checkbox. Okay, now what I'm going to do is that here, okay, here let me open label tag. Why? Because this skills is a label, right? So let me open label tag here. Let me type skills. Let me close it over here. Okay, let me save it, control S, and let me show you in my browser so you can see the label, right? Skills, you can see the label, right? Wait, let me show you. Okay, now you can see. Okay, now I need to code the skills: artificial intelligence, machine learning, web development. Okay, so a particular user can have more than one skills, so I need to provide the capability to select more than one choices, or we can say I want my user to select multiple choices. Okay, so we can achieve this with the help of checkbox input. Okay, checkbox input. So let me open input tag over here. Okay, so input is self closing tag, so let me close it. So input type is, in the type attribute I need to specify checkbox, right? In the type attribute I need to specify checkbox, so I need to specify some name. Okay, so let me specify some name like skills. Okay, why I am specifying square bracket here I will explain after coding, don't worry. So if you want to code checkbox type input, in the name attribute you need to specify value. In addition to that you need to put square bracket also. So I will explain why we are doing like this. Okay, now how many skills are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, right? So let me paste it for 8 more times. Copy and paste it for 8 more times. Okay, so now okay. Now, so far we coded type and name attribute. Okay. Now here you can see the label, right? Artificial intelligence, machine learning, web development, graph theory, deep learning. What are these? These things are label, right? So let me code it by using label tag here. So let me open a particular tag and let me close it over here. Okay, similarly, I'm going to do this for all pins. Let me copy this and let me paste it over here. Okay, now let me copy each and every field. Okay, first artificial intelligence, right? So let me paste it over here. Similarly, next machine learning. Similarly, web development. Graph theory. Deep learning. Okay, let me paste it over here. Cyber security. Okay, now fuzzy systems. Okay, app development. Okay, next, switching techniques. Okay, now let me save this, control S, and let me show in my browser. Here you can see. Let me use DR tag also. Okay, let me use it over here. Okay, now here you can see. Okay, we coded these things now. But similarly, now let me select something here like artificial intelligence, app development, web development. Okay, let me send. So what you can see in the URL? See, in the URL, you can see on. Here also on. We selected three things, right? On. Okay, so by seeing this, we cannot identify what are the things selected by your user. Okay, for that we need to specify value, right? For that we need to specify some unique value to all the things, right? So let me specify some value here, like value AI. Okay, value should be in understandable form. Okay, you want to understand your own value. By seeing this, you need to understand. So let me copy for everything. Let me specify some ML. ML stands for machine learning, right? Similarly here, web development, here graph theory. So let me remove this value. Okay, similarly here, deep learning, right? Here, cyber security. Let me specify some CS. We can specify any value, but it should be in user understandable form. Fuzzy systems. Let me specify something, FZ. Similarly here, let me specify something, AD, app development. Similarly, here, switching techniques, like ST. Okay, now control S. Now, let me show you in my browser. Okay, now here you can see I am selecting something: machine learning, graph theory, and cyber security. Okay, we can select how much we want. Okay, user can select as much as user can. Okay, so let me click send. Now here you can see the value ML and GT and CS. We selected these things and we selected one more thing, right? So you can see this in the URL. Yes, the switching techniques, right? So you can see this in the URL. Okay, so if you want to identify which input is chosen by user, you need to give some value. Okay, here user will enter some value, so that value will appended in URL. That value will append in URL. Okay, but here user just clicking, right? So we need to provide value, right? Okay, user may click any radio button, user may click any checkbox. So we need to provide value. It is our duty to code value there. Okay, so this is what the main purpose of value attribute. Okay, so what is the main difference between these things? Here gender, user will choose only one gender. User can have only one gender, right? User cannot have both gender, right? But a single user can have many skills, right? So for that you need to provide the capability for the user to select more than one options, or we can say you need to provide the capability for the user to select multiple choices. For that purpose we are using checkbox. Okay, checkbox. Now you may have one question, why here I gave similar name, gender, similarly here skills. Okay, why? Because see, this is a particular field, right? So for a particular field, user can choose either male, female, or others. Okay, but this field is dedicated to gender, right? So as I said, for each and every field name should be unique, right? So this field name should be unique, gender. Inside that particular field name can be same. Okay, similarly here why I am using square bracket is that, see, here if you use without square bracket, see, if I select artificial intelligence, after that if I select some web development, okay, web development will be override by artificial intelligence. Okay, or first if I select artificial intelligence, then I'm selecting web development. Okay, so artificial intelligence will disappear, web development will override artificial intelligence. Okay, can you get my point? See, this is all some back end programming. You cannot understand these things now. As of now, you please remember, if you want to code some checkbox in the name attribute, you need to specify value in addition to square bracket, right? So this is some back end programming. You cannot understand these things now. Okay, if you use square bracket, our system will treat these things as array. Okay, we can array in the sense that is some programming language. So if you please remember like this now. Okay, if you use some checkbox, if you want to code some checkbox, you need to specify square bracket in the name attribute, okay, in addition to the value. Okay, so if you didn't specify square bracket, what will happen is that if user select multiple choices, okay, we can see only the last choice which is selected by user. Remaining three choices will disappear. Okay, last choice will override the remaining choices. Okay, if user chooses some six options, we can see only last option, remaining five options, the first five options will be override by the last option. Last option will override the remaining option. Okay, so this is some backend programming. Okay, in backend only we can see these things. So we can learn these things detailedly while discussing about backend programming. So as of now, you please remember, while coding checkbox, in the name attribute you need to specify square bracket in addition to the value. Okay, that if you specify like this, then only you can get all the value, you can retrieve all the inputs which are specified by user. Okay, if you specify without square bracket, you can get the last input which was chosen by user. You cannot get the remaining inputs. Okay, so these things will be discussing in back-end programming. As of now, you please remember like this. Okay, so for here also, you can see here I gave same name. Why? Because this is a particular field, right? For a particular field, name should be unique. Okay, each and every field should contain unique name. For a particular field, or we can say for similar field, okay, for similar field, name can be same, no problem. Okay, for similar field, name can be same. So far we coded from this birth month is pending, right? So far we completed how to code radio button and how to code checkbox. Okay, in inputs we completed number inputs, radio inputs and checkbox inputs. Now we are going to see how to code drop down menu in HTML web page. To code drop down menu, we'll be using these two tags, select tag and option tag. Okay, to code drop down menu, we'll be using these two tags, select tag and option tag. Okay, we'll be using these two tags. So this is our final topic in today's video. So let us discuss this, how to code like this. User can select anything. If user want March, he can select this thing. If user born in August, he can select this thing. Okay, now let me explain how to code this birth month. Okay, how to code this type of drop down menu. Okay, now let me explain. So for that, as I said earlier, we'll be using two tags, select tag and option tag. Let me explain how to use this, how to code this. Okay, so first birth month is label, right? So what we need to do, we need to use label tag, right? So label, let me close it over here. Okay, so birth month. Okay, birth month. See, now here you can see birth month, right? Here you can see the label. So let me use br tag also, so you can see with space. Now let me show you here. Here you can see the label birth month, right? Now I'm going to code this drop down menu. Okay, I'm going to code this drop down menu. Let me explain how to do this. As I said earlier, we'll be using two tags here, select tag and option tag. To code drop down menu in HTML web page, we'll be using two tags. Okay, to code drop down menu in HTML web page, we'll be using two tags, select tag and option tag. So let me open select tag here and let me close it over here. Okay, let me close it over here. Okay, inside here I'll be using option tag. Okay, so let me close it over here. Okay, these are not self-closing tags. If a particular tag is open, the particular tag needs to get closed. Inside select tag, I will be using option tag. Okay, I need to close it over here. Okay, here I have how many options? 12. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, right? So let me copy it for 12 times. Let me copy it. Please wait patiently. Okay. Let me copy. Okay. Now I copied these many times. So let me code over here. Okay, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November,
and visible.
Okay, let me specify some unique value. Okay, if you didn't specify value, in the URL you cannot see anything. Okay, you can see only on. Okay, we just saw for radio button and checkbox, right? Okay, let me give some name over here. We can give common name in the select attribute itself. Okay, so let me give some name like birth month. Okay, now let me show you. See, here now let me select any month, February. Let me click send button. Okay, what you can see here, birth month is equal to February, right? Why? Because I have chosen February here. Okay, so what value I chosen here? February. Okay, if you want any other value, you can specify value attribute also. Okay, see, now let me specify value equal to some, see, value equal to Feb here, control S. Now let me show the difference. See, let me choose February. Control S. See, now you can see birth month is equal to February, right? Wait. Birth month equal to February, right? Now let me code value for all options also. Let me explain. Please wait patiently. Let me code some value over here. Value is equal to April. Similarly, if you want, you can code value field also. Okay, value field is optional over here. Value is equal to June. Value is equal to July. Value is equal to August. Value is equal to some September. Value equal to October. Okay, similarly here also value is equal to November. Value is equal to December. Now let me save this. Now let me show you here. Okay, now let me choose some month like June. Send. What you can see here, see, birth month is equal to value, right? So birth month is what? Name field, right? What I gave name here, birth month. What is the value I selected there? June. So you can see. Okay, you can see it. Similarly, let me select some other month like January. Now you can see here. Send. Now you can see birth month is equal to Jan, right? So if you want some value to be displayed, so Jan is the value, right? So you can see Jan here. Similarly, see, let me explain the difference now. See, let me remove value for this February. Okay, control S. Now see, let me select February here. Okay, send. What you can see, birth month is equal to, sorry, first let me save it. Control S. Okay, now see, I'm going to select February here. Okay, send. Okay, here what you can see, birth month is equal to February, right? Because I didn't specify any value here. Okay, I didn't specify any value here. For that, I clicked February, right? So system by default, it takes February as a value, and that particular thing is appended in URL. Name is birth month. Okay. Now let me specify some value like Feb. Control S. Okay. Now similarly, I'm going to select February month. Now send. So what you can see, the value, right? What value I specify, that value you can see, right? So if you want some value to specify, so you can do this with the help of value attribute, no problem. Okay, so here value attribute is optional. If you didn't specify value attribute, if a user clicks this particular February will display it as a value. If you specify something here as a value attribute, okay, if you specify something here as a value attribute, that particular thing will be taken as a value. If user click February, that this February will be taken as a value and that particular thing will be displayed. Okay, so this is how you need to code the drop down menu. Okay, so now let me close it over here. Control S. Now let me show you. Okay, hope you can see this. Okay, now we created the form like this, right? So now see here, by default select your birth month is there, right? But here by default January is selected, right? January is selected, right? So to avoid this, what you can do is that prior to this, you can open one more option tag. Okay, and here you can specify some value, like you can specify some dummy value here. And okay, here you can specify the content as birth month. Control S. Now birth month is there. You can select any birth month. Okay. Now we are end of the session. So before ending the session, I want to ask you some questions. Okay. Before ending the session, I want to ask you some questions. Okay. That's it. We completed our agenda, right? So we completed how to code radio button. We have seen how to code radio button, how to code checkbox, and how to code drop down menu. We have seen. For coding this, we are using these three inputs, number inputs. To code phone number, we are using number input. To code radio button, we are using radio input. To code checkbox, we used the checkbox input. To code drop down menu, we use these two tags, select tag and option tag, right? So we completed our agenda. Now I want to, before ending my session, I want to ask some questions to you. Okay, see, let me enter some password here, like HTML. We used password text type, right? We use password input type, right? So why we use password input type? To mask the characters, right? Now let me specify some password here. Let me send it. Now here you can see in the URL, you can see my password, right? Password equal to HTML. This is what I typed, right? So in the URL, you can see the password. That means in the URL, my password is visible, right? In the URL, my password is visible, right? So what is the purpose of using the password input type? To mask the characters, right? But in the URL, you can see my password, right? So then what is the purpose of the password input type? Mainly password should be masked, but in the URL you can see the password visibly, right? So how to avoid this? Any idea how to avoid this? Okay, please think. For this, I will explain the answer in next video. Similarly, see, first name should be limited by characters, right? For example, name should contain maximum of some 30 characters. We cannot enter 100 or 1000 characters there, right, in this particular field. Okay, so how to limit this? A user should contain only a particular yes, user should enter only characters below than 30. Okay, user name should not exceed 30 characters. How to limit this? How to do these restrictions? Any idea? So I will explain answer in next video. Similarly, one more question. See, if I didn't select anything, let me send here. Okay, let me send here. There is nothing there for gender and for skills, right? Okay, so if I want something to be selected by default, for example, if I want something to be selected female or male, like by default, how to do this? See, for example, you imagine for school students, there is a field called marital status. For school students, marital status will be single, right? Mostly single, right? So single can be selected default. By default, single can be selected there by default. So how to achieve this? So these questions, I request you to think answers for these questions. Okay, so you can refer some HTML books if you have. Okay, so I will explain detailed answers for these questions in next video. So these steps we are going to discuss in next video, or we'll be discussing in future videos. Okay, so that's all for today. I hope I completed my agenda. Thank you so much for your patience listening. Let me end up my session. Okay, thank you so much for your patience listening. If this video is useful to you, kindly subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you will receive all notifications of my videos then and there. If this video is useful to you, please hit the like button. Share this playlist to your friends and relatives, those who are interested in learning HTML or those who are interested to become a web developer. If you have any suggestions or if you have any doubts regarding this video, or if you feel any difficulties, you can ping me in the comment section, or you can mail me personally. My mail ID is in the description box. Thank you so much for your patience listening. So see you all in my next video. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.